Subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Welcome back to Best Way to Study. This is one of the most requested video from all the students who are going to attend the MCAT. So watch this video till the end. This video we're going to discuss the last 15 days most effective plan in order to get good score in MCAT. Okay, so make sure you watch the video till the end, and also don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll be notified whenever I make a new video. So now let's begin the video without delay. So first of all, as we have very few days left for MCAT, we need to be prepared that we need to invest at least 12 hours per day for MCAT preparation. Now let's look into MCAT preparation plan for last 15 days. Let's discuss day 1 schedule. In day 1, from morning 5 a.m. to 7 a.m., Prepare all the important problems from calculus, because calculus has really high weightage. Okay, calculus is one of the most important chapter coming to MCAT mathematics. We are expecting around 15 questions will be appeared in this year's MCAT exam. And then after 2 hours of preparation of calculus, take a small break for approximately 1 hour. Get ready, fresh up, have your breakfast, and sit down again for studying from 8:30. Okay, so from 8:30 to approximately around 10:30, these 2 hours you need to invest your time on trigonometry. Trigonometry is also the second most important chapter coming to MCAT mathematics. Around 10 questions will be asked from this particular chapter. From 12 to 1, start studying physics. You need to cover motion in a straight line in day 1 schedule. After completion of your studies at 1 a.m., take a small break till 2:30 and then resume your studies from 2:30 p.m. Start your preparation and continue studying motion in a straight line. And coming to motion in a straight line, around 2 questions will be asked every year from this particular chapter. After 3:30, start preparing laws of motion for 2 more hours, that is from 3:30 to 5:30. As of the motion is also one of the most important chapter, where around 3 to 4 questions will be asked every year from this particular chapter. Once you are done with the preparation of this particular chapter, take a small break from 5:30 to 7 and then resume back to your studies from 7 o'clock. Okay, this duration of 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. start preparing atomic structure and chemical bonding, where you will be asked minimum of 4 plus questions from this particular chapter. And once you are done with the preparation of this particular chapter, take a break for 1 more hour and resume back to your studies at 10 p.m. 10 p.m. to 11 p.m. you need not study anything, but what you need to do is you need to revise everything whatever you studied the entire day. This helps you to memorize the things for long time. The students can replace their subjects with physics and chemistry. Coming to the day 2 schedule, from morning 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. start preparing algebra chapter. Then once you are done with your studies at 7 a.m. take a small break and resume back to your studies at 8:30 a.m. 8:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. you need to start preparing probability. Coming to trigonometry, you will be asked around 12 plus questions in every year. Coming to probability, you will be asked around 6 plus questions every year. And then from 12 to 1, start preparing oscillations. From 2:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m., continue studying with oscillations. And 4:30 to 5:30, start preparing to your new chapter, which is gravitation. And resume back to your studies at 7 p.m. and 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. start preparing from chemistry, which is thermodynamics. From 10 p.m. to 11 p.m. revise all the things which you have studied from morning to evening. So coming to the day 3 schedule, from morning 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. start preparing from vector algebra. Approximately 5 plus questions will be asked from this particular chapter. Take a small break and resume back to your studies from 8:30 a.m. From 8:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. start preparing from coordinate geometry. Around 15 plus questions will be asked even from this chapter. 11:30 a.m. to 1 p.m. start studying system of particles and rotational motion. Small break and resume back to your studies from 2:30 p.m. and from 2:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. start studying motion in a plane. After this, take a small break and resume back to your studies from 7 p.m. From 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. start preparing the solutions chapter from chemistry. And coming to the day 4 schedule, from morning 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. start preparing units and measurements. And from morning 8:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. study questions from the chapter physical world. 11:30 a.m. to 1 p.m. start studying questions from work, power and energy. Take a small break and resume back by from 3 p.m. to 4 p.m. Continue your studies from work, energy and power to 4 to 6. Start studying gaseous and liquid states. And from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. revise the mathematics questions. And coming to the day 5 schedule, from morning 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. start preparing solutions. And from morning 8:30 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. start preparing P block elements, which is one of the most important chapters coming to chemistry. And from 2:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. start preparing solid state. And from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. start preparing from chemical kinematics, which is also one of the most important chapters. Now let's see the schedule for day 6. From morning 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. start preparing questions from waves. From 8 a.m. to 11 a.m. start preparing from kinetic theory. Take 1 hour break and resume back to studies by 12 p.m. and 12 p.m. to 1 p.m. revise the mathematics chapters which you have studied so far. And from 2:30 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. start preparing questions from hydrocarbon. Resume back to your studies at 7 p.m. and from 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. what you need to do is note down the most important formula so that you will have chance to revise them daily from now so that you can easily memorize them during your exams. And coming to day 7 schedule, from morning 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. start preparing carboxylic acids. A small break and resume back to your studies by 8:30 a.m. and from 8:30 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. start preparing questions from polymers. And from 2 p.m. to 5 p.m. concentrate completely on mathematics, whatever topics you are weak at. Coming to 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. start studying questions from electric charges and fields. This is also important chapter. Coming to the day 8 schedule, from morning 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. start preparing the questions from moving charges and magnetism. From 8:30 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. start preparing the questions from the mathematics. 2 p.m. to 5 p.m. start preparing the questions from alternating current. And coming to the day 9 schedule, morning 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. start preparing the topics from the chemistry. It is carbohydrate. 8:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. ordination compounds. And coming to afternoon 2 to 5, concentrate completely on mathematics. 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. start preparing questions from F block elements. Keep this specific time to prepare the topics in which you are weak at so that you can gain good marks even in those topics. And coming to evening 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. concentrate on physics, dual nature of radiation and matter. And coming to night 10 p.m. to 11 p.m. revise everything. And coming to day 10 schedule, from morning 5 a.m. to 7 a.m. start studying electromagnetic waves. And coming to 8:30 a.m. to 10:30 a.m. start preparing questions from alternating current. From 11:30 a.m. to 1 p.m. start studying mathematics questions and continue the same from 2:30 p.m. to 4:30 p.m. And coming to 4:30 p.m. to 5:30 p.m. amino acids and proteins. Coming to 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. start studying all the formula and start preparing from the important notes which you have maintained so far. Coming to night 10 p.m. to 11 p.m. revise all the things which you have studied for entire day. So coming to the next 5 day schedule, you need to just revise all the things which you have studied all these 10 days, because whatever I told you to prepare coming to these 10 days are really, really important.